Hello, I'm Wayne Bodin, a principal product architect here at One Identity. In this short video presentation, I'll be discussing the challenges and best practices surrounding service accounts. So what are some of the key challenges? First of all, identifying service accounts. What is out there? Who knows what's out there? What accounts are they running? Are the passwords for those accounts being managed? Do we know when the last time they were changed? Do we know what happens if I was to reset and restart the service? These are some of the key concerns when discussing service accounts with some of our customers. And lastly, is no auditing or notification of services being used by anyone. These are just some of the controls that concern some of our customers out there today. So when we look at best practices, ideally, we want to take control over the life cycle of the service account. We want to implement a PAM solution. We want to have functionality such as account discovery, service discovery, auto provisioning and management. Lastly, once we have that account under management, we want to build the role-based controls around the account, allowing users to check out the credential if necessary. These are some of the things that the Safeguard Privileged Passwords can help you do. In today's demonstration, I'll be showing you the 5 steps to service account management with Safeguard Privileged Passwords. First step, account discovery. Second step, service discovery. Third step, assigning dynamic tags to the new accounts that were recently discovered by Safeguard. Taking those new accounts, using the tags, assigning them to a dynamic group. And in turn, assigning those dynamic groups to an entitlement slash access request policy. Here's an overview of my lab configuration. It's a simple environment with one SPP, Safeguard for Privileged Password, a single domain controller, and a member server. On the member server is a Kiwi syslog server running as a service using a domain account called svc_kiwi. Let's take a look at Safeguard. All right, so here's my lab, already logged into Safeguard. Also have the services MSC running. Just for shins and giggles, let's go ahead and restart the service, make sure it's actually up and running. Kiwi syslog server, so I just stopped and started. What we're gonna do next is step 1. We're gonna look for the account discovery. So I'm gonna go ahead and select administration tools, highlight the domain controller itself, right mouse click, discover accounts. Let's run for a few seconds. Once it's completed, we'll go ahead and refresh the Safeguard client. So we'll go ahead and hit refresh. You'll notice I've discovered 3 accounts. At this point, if I was to restart the service on the member server, it'll fail because I've changed the actual password on the domain, but I haven't synchronized it with Safeguard yet as far as the account discovery goes for services. So step 2 is really looking at the services discovery. So I'm gonna go ahead and on the member server, select, just like we did with the domain controller, right mouse click. This time I'm gonna do discover services. This is gonna go out and discover the actual Kiwi syslog server, make it as a dependent system. You'll see it here as a dependent system. Now, if I was to go back, actually, even before I do that, let's go ahead and restart. We can see it's now successful. Because not only did the discovery go and reset the password, but it also synchronized it with that of the domain controller. Because it's now a dependent system. So if I was to go back to the DC one last time, let's go and reset this password. Let's go to accounts. Right mouse click, account security, change password. I'm gonna refresh the service over here. So you'll notice it stopped, and now starting and running. So we can see that simply by Safeguard Privileged Passwords managing the service account on the domain controller, once the reset schedule change is done or manually, like I'm doing today, it's going out to the member server, resetting the password, stopping and restarting the service. So how is this accomplished? So let's take a look at Safeguard. So again, we'll just make this window a little bigger. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna look at the discovery rules. So you notice I have 4 account discoveries defined. The first one that we ran was a directory discovery. So I'm gonna go ahead and just double click it, give it a name in this example. I'm gonna go ahead and select the rule and edit the rule. So the first thing I'm doing is I'm looking for the service accounts using an LDAP filter. So simply using the LDAP filter, I'm looking inside the domain controller, inside the domain, if you will, for any account called SVC underscore star. Bring that into view. I'm then selecting a default password, assigning it, and then I'm giving it a Windows, a password profile called Windows Services. So this will go out, discover the account, assign the Windows, the password profile called Windows Services, automatically add those credentials to Safeguard. So that would be considered step one in the diagram. Step two is looking for the actual services running on a target machine. So here we have another job called Find Local Services. Again, click it to edit, give it a name, schedule. Down below, I'm looking for the option to discover the services. Now automatically configure dependent systems. So this is what adds the Abzure OneServe, if you will, as a dependent system for that service account credential. Again, double click, give it a property constraint. Basically, I'm using a regex expression to look for the service running. And then again, same idea, assigning the password profile to Windows Services. Key point, when doing the discovery, the profile must match on both the domain controller for the password as well as of that of the domain, the member server running the service as well. So that allows us to basically make that service a dependent system of the target machine. Step three was really assigning the dynamic tag to the account. So if I was to go under settings, tags, we can see here I have a single tag name called SVC. And what this is doing is looking at the account rules. And after the accounts are discovered, it's dynamically assigning the tag name for any account that starts with SVC. So again, if I was to preview this, it's going to go out and list the three accounts that are going to assign the tags. Again, cancel. If I go back to my accounts, let's do a refresh here. I'll see the new accounts coming in. Simply select any one of the service accounts. You'll notice at the bottom of the page, I now have a tag called SVC. With these tags assigned, I'm then creating a dynamic account group. So let's go to account groups. And again, you'll notice the SVC account group that is dynamically assigned. Again, I'm going to double click to edit it. And looking at the account rules, now I'm saying for any account that has a tag that equals SVC, I'm going to add that account to this dynamic group. So again, if I was to go under accounts, you'll see the actual account itself. The last step, right, is the entitlement, step five. If we go under entitlements and look at the SVC accounts, I can see the users that are assigned to this entitlement, the access request policies. Now, if I was to go and just double click to edit this access request policy, we can see here that it's loaded. Most importantly, I'm going to go to the scope, and we can see that that dynamic group is now assigned to this access request policy. So from an auto discovery point of view, the minute that the account is discovered, it is put automatically under management in Safeguard. It's assigned a tag to the account. The account is then assigned to the group. The group is assigned to the entitlement. So at this point, from an end user perspective, I could easily go to the home screen, new request, select the domain controller, select the accounts, and you'll see that my service accounts are now available to be requested by the user. And again, this is all automatically dynamically assigned within Safeguard. Let's go next. I'm going to do an emergency request simply because it bypasses the approval process. And again, automatically made available, expand, show the password for the credential. Again, once the user is done, simply check in the user request. And that would complete the workflow from a user perspective. Thanks for watching. I hope you've enjoyed watching this short video clip.